Okay, in this query, I want to show you how to do an example using a yes-no field. A yes-no is also like an on or off type of situation. So we're going to go into the products table. I'm just going to double-click on that. And this shows all of our products. If you notice down here, it says that we have 96 records. So I'm going to scroll over. We have the product name, the supplier, the units in stock. And then over here, we have a discontinued field. Notice how it comes up as a checkbox. That means it's a yes-no field. So when the check mark is there, that means it's yes. When the check mark is not there, that means it's no. So I'm going to close that window. Let's say we only want to see the ones that are, in fact, discontinued. We're going to make a new query here. So on the top of my screen, I'll pick on Create. And then I'm going to pick on Query Design. Most of your queries will be made in Query Design. We're going to pick on the Products table. And we'll pick on close for the show table window. In this case, I'd like to see the product ID, the product name, maybe the units in stock, the unit price, and the discontinued field. So of course, I'm just double clicking on those fields. When I run the query, it shows me still all of the records, right? So let's go back to design view. Doing the criteria for a yes-no field is very simple. We're going to go to the criteria of the discontinued field, and I'm just going to type in the word yes. That's how easy these can be. You can use the language yes or true, and that will give you the ones that are filled in, or you can use the language no or false. That will give you the ones that are not filled in, okay? Or sometimes I've even seen people use like a one or a zero. But for most of us, we would just use yes or no, or true or false. We're going to run that. Notice that we only have the ones that are filled in. So these are all of our discontinued products. If I wanted to see the ones that were not filled in, then for the criteria, I would use the word no instead of yes. So yes-no fields come up all the time. Maybe you have seasonal products at your company. Is it seasonal, yes or no? So these do come up. And the way to put the criteria in for a yes-no field is you can either use the language yes or no, or you can use the language true or false. Sometimes I've even seen ones and zeros, but I think most of us would like to use yes or no or true or false. So that's how we do criteria on a yes-no field. Now I'm actually going to save this query. We're going to close that. We'll save that, and I'll call it discontinued products.